The other day I was in the gym and I was working out, and I found myself during my workout being distracted with people around me, conversations that are taking place, people walking in the door, things on the TV. I just found myself being distracted and really not concentrating on what I was doing in my workout. And I started thinking about that, thinking about distractions and how easy it is for you and I to get distracted. You know, it's so easy driving a car to get distracted. I mean, unfortunately, millions of people die every year from car wrecks because of distractions, getting distracted, whether it's texting on a cell phone or radio or something. We get distracted, and it's so easy for us to get distracted. I mean, like, yeah, you know what I'm talking about. By getting distracted, it's so easy. Where was I again? Yeah, distractions. It's so easy for that to happen, and we get distracted in school, get distracted at work, and we just kind of, what happens is we lose focus, and when we lose that concentration, and we lose that moment. And I started thinking about this spiritually. What happens to us spiritually? And I started thinking about, you know, distraction has to be Satan's probably number one tool. And because if he can get us distracted from listening or paying attention to what God's trying to say to us, then he's winning. And I came across this verse this morning, as a matter of fact, Joshua 1:8. And listen to what it says. It talks about distractions. This is what it says. Joshua 1:8 says this. It says, study this book of instruction continually. Meditate on it day and night, so you will be sure to obey everything written in it. Only then will you prosper and succeed in all that you do. And I'm sitting there reading that going, wow. God's telling us right here, I mean, in the beginning, the Old Testament, or Joshua going, look, if you study my word, if you meditate on this, think about these things, then you're going to be prosper. You're going to prosper. You're going to be able to succeed in life. You see, because a lot of us, I believe we read the Bible, kind of read it like it's a book, but we don't meditate on it. We don't think about what we've really read. We don't see how can we apply that to our lives. What does this mean for me? We just gotta read through it just so we can have, quote unquote, have our quiet time and feel good. But he says here, if we want to prosper, if we want to be successful, we need to meditate on it. We need to know what his book says. Because the Bible, what is it? That is the instruction manual. I mean, God created us. He created you and he created me. He created this world. God is the one that's in control. Whether we like to think we're in control, but God is in control. And this is what he desires. He desires for us to be successful. That's what he desires. And he desires for us to be successful in everything that we do. But a lot of times, the stuff that we do when we're making decisions, when we're thinking about stuff, when we're worrying about making a purchase, whatever, we never consult God. We never look to him. We just kind of do it on our own. You see, if the Bible's are all our owner's manual, it's kind of foolish for us to go through this life not understanding what it says, not reading it, not meditating on it. And God gives us an incredible promise here that you will be successful. And I don't know anybody who does not want to be successful in life. And so many of us, we want success, but we want to do it our way. Well, God says that the only way you can be successful is if you do it my way. And the only way to do it his way is that we meditate on his word and we understand what it says. We know what it says. So I want to challenge you. You know, we're entering into springtime, you know, spring break, and it's going to be easy to get distracted. But to make time to meditate on God's word, spend time with him, reading his word, not just to read it for devotion, but to read it, to meditate on it, to glean something from it, to apply it to your life. Because that's the only way that you and I are going to be successful, is by meditating on his word. He's given us the promise. Now it's up to you and it's up to me to do that. So let's say, you know, goodbye with distractions. Is it fooey on that? It's enough, been enough. Let's be successful. Let's be successful. And let's have a great summer. Let's go in having a great summer, having a great time. Let's be successful this year. Let's put God first. Let's meditate on His Word. Let's live for Him. Let's glorify Him in everything that we do. And may He work in us and work through us so that this world that we live in today will know who Jesus is and know that true success only comes from Him. I love you guys. I can't wait to see you again next week.